Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 120th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 665.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1083, then landed successfully for the sixth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage one landing confirmed.
A few hours later, SpaceX also successfully launched their 121st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NROL 126. The booster which launched this mission, B1088, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Coming into clearer view.
Stage one landing confirmed.
This week we can hopefully expect to see at least a few missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 914 mission, is currently scheduled for Wednesday 4th at 12:29 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 3rd at 7:29 p.m. EST. The following day, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 670 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 5th at 8:02 a.m. UTC or 3:02 a.m. EST. Then, later the same day, we should see a customer mission launch. The SXM-9 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 5th at 4:10 p.m. UTC or 11:10 a.m. EST. Gwynne Shotwell gave some information on when SpaceX could wind down the Falcon and Dragon program. This article says Starship obsoletes Falcon 9 and Dragon capsule, Shotwell said. Now, we are not shutting down Dragon and we are not shutting down Falcon 9. We'll be flying that for 6 to 8 more years, but ultimately people are going to want to fly on Starship. Alex from NSF posted an interesting picture of a longer Falcon fairing. He said, "I may be seeing things, but I believe this on the side of the second picture is a Falcon long fairing. It's a bit pixelated due to the distance, but one can see it has a Falcon Heavy logo on it and maybe what appears to be a US flag as well. First time we see the long fairing." Heading to Boca Chica, the crane assembly continues at the launch site. Work continues on the orbital pad A launch pad as they prepare for flight 7. Some pipes were seen being installed for the orbital pad B launch pad. The stabilizers on the pad A chopsticks were seen being painted. Work continues on the office building Star Factory connection. There was an interesting post about items recovered from Starship 31 which flew on flight 6. It says Starship S31's debris have returned to Australia. All sorts of items ranging from tiles, COPV tanks and other components from the Starship upper stage have been brought back to shore for further analysis. The scrapped Starship 26 nose cone was seen being moved out of the high bay. The booster 16 aft section was seen moving over to Mega Bay 1 from Star Factory. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.